The federal carbon tax will come into effect in April, but only in four provinces: Ontario, Manitoba, Saskatchewan, and New Brunswick. So if you live in another province, congratulations, you're already living under some form of carbon price approved by Environment Minister Catherine McKenna, or you very soon will be. So what do you need to know? Well, some things are about to get more expensive, like gasoline and home heating fuel, for instance. The federal government expects that gas prices will go up about 4.5 cents in 2019 because of the federal carbon price. And some other things like groceries will probably get a little bit more expensive because transportation costs are going to go up. But the government wants to make up for that by giving most of the carbon tax revenue back to you, the taxpayer. But just don't expect to get a check in the mail. Under this plan, every household will receive a rebate after you file your income taxes this spring. It will either be subtracted from what you owe or added to what you get back. So, for example, for an average household in Ontario, you're expected to spend about $244 on the carbon tax this year, but you'll get back about $300. Now you might be thinking, if I'm going to make back more than I pay on the carbon tax, where is the incentive for me to reduce emissions? Well, the government argues that the more you reduce emissions, the better off you'll be, so the incentive still exists. Imagine you walk into a bar that has a Carlsberg tax. So while most beers cost $5, Carlsberg actually costs $10. But when you walk into the bar, you get a $5 rebate. Well, some people will still go and order a Carlsberg, use their $5 rebate, and end up paying $5 for a Carlsberg. But some other savvy customers are going to pocket that $5 rebate. They're going to go and get a Stella, which costs $5 to start with, and they'll end up basically getting free beer. So even though some people will still drink Carlsberg just like before, there's still a big incentive to change your behavior. That's basically how the government hopes this federal carbon tax will work. And starting this year, we're going to find out if they're right.